In this video, we are going to see the instruction set of microprocessor 8085. So we'll see one by one. Here we are going to see just an introduction. Already in the previous video, we have seen about the three types of instruction, that is based on the instruction size, word size, 1 byte, 2 byte and 3 byte. For this, we have seen the examples. Anyway, here just I give a small intro and then we'll move on to the next. So opcode, and any the instruction has two parts. One is the opcode and the operand. See, for example, this is an instruction, move C, A. This is an instruction. In this, the opcode is this and operand is that. So what is opcode? The operation to be performed. And what is operand? On which the operation is performed. Whether it is a register or data or the memory location. These are the three types of operands available in the instruction set as well as in 8085. So what are the operand available? Registers and then memory location and then data. So based on only these three will come here. So based on the whatever data, whatever the operand comes here, it will be a 1 byte, 2 byte or 3 byte. If it is completely registers, operand consists of only register, then mostly it will be a 1 byte instruction, that is 8 bit. If it consists of register and data like this, the user can enter the data here, their own data, then it will be a 2 byte instruction. If the information in the operand is a 16 bit address, then it will be mostly it will be a 3 byte instruction, because this itself takes a 8 bit and definitely address will take 16 bit. So put together 24 bit, which is nothing but 3 byte. So an instruction has basically two parts. One is opcode and another one is operand. Based on the operand, it varies whether it is a 1 byte, 2 byte or 3 byte. Okay. So now if you see this example, move C, A, all these are fixed. For this definite hex code is available. Okay. For this, it is 4F. If it is C, B, it will be a different hex code and all these are fixed by the manufacturer. That is why it is a single byte. Then here MVA, for MVA A, we have one hex code and for the data another code, which is because since the data is given by the user, it depends upon the hex code provided by the user. So if it is MVA A, MVA B, MVA C and so on, it has their own hex code and all those hex code are fixed. If you see MVA A, it is 3E, then data will be the next byte. So how it will be stored? For this, it will be in a, it occupies a single location, because we know that in microprocessor, main memory can occupy only an 8 bit in each location. So you can store 8 bit in each and every location. So here, single byte occupies one memory location, whereas 2 byte occupies two memory location. So how you have to enter? First, you have to enter the data, that is hex code of the opcode, and then the data, okay, hex code of this data. Then 3 byte, first it consists of opcode. It is nothing but it says jumping, okay, jump to a particular location, to where it is a particular location. So here location is 16 bit. So how you can enter, it will occupy 3 memory location, because it is a 3 byte, so it occupies 3 memory location. So how you have to enter? First you have to enter the opcode, hex code, and then the location. While entering the location, first you will be entering the higher order bit, the lower order bit and then the higher order bit. So if you see that 85 is entered first and then 20. So this is what already we have seen in the previous video. So just a small introduction I have given. Now we'll move to the next one. Types of instruction. Based on the operation, what they do, whether they are doing movement of data or doing any logical operations or arithmetic operations, we divide them into some 5 groups. The instruction sets are divided into 5 groups. So here, data transfer operations, arithmetic operations, logical operations, branch operations, and machine control operations. So since it is an 8085 is an 8-bit device, how many combinations it can have is 2^8 is 256 instructions it can have. How it is 256 instructions? Say for example, it is move C, A means then move B, A, move D, A, and so on. Then if it is move A, B, move A, C, A, B, and so on. So like that, you can have different combinations. That way we have 256. But in generally we have here, we can have 256, but this has only 246 combinations and unique 74 instructions. If it is move, that will be considered as one unique instructions, just move. Then the registers may vary. So that combinations will increase the combinations, but unique 74 instructions are that. Then we will see one by one. First, we'll see the data transfer instructions. What is data? The name itself says the data is moved from one register to another register, then memory location to registers, or from registers to memory locations. Then the data itself is supplied by the user so that it can be moved to some other registers, or it can be moved to memory, and so on. So they transfer data between registers, data byte to a register or memory locations, data between a memory location and a register, and data between I/O device and the accumulator. These are the different types of data transfer operations that can be performed. So the data in this, whatever it is, here we say that it is a move instruction. But move means actually the value is moved from one place to another place, so that the source may not have that value. But here it is not that meaning. It is copied. Say for example, move the value from B register to A register means B register also, the information will be there. After moving, accumulator A will also have the value. So it is not actually moving, it is copying the content. Okay, even if the instruction is move, it is nothing but it is copying the content of one register to another register. So some of the data transfer instructions are LDA, STA, move, LDAX, STAX, MVA, LXA, etc. And they don't affect movement of information, will not affect the flag bits. The next is arithmetic operations. They do addition, subtraction, multiplication, comparison, etc. These operations are always performed with accumulator. So even if we don't give explicitly the value register A, implied the other registers take accumulator as the implied register, and the operations will be carried over there. So for example, add B means add the value of accumulator and B register and store the result back in accumulator. That is the meaning of that particular instruction. But accumulator is not at all appearing in the instruction add A comma B. We don't give as add A comma B. We just say add B. So it is implied. Accumulator is implied. That's what the meaning of this. All the operations are performed with accumulator as one of the operands. The status of the result can be verified by the content of the flag register. The flag registers will be affected by the addition, subtraction, and compare operations. Now we have more many arithmetic operation related instructions like add, ADI, sub, SBI, INR, DCR, and so on. We will see in the next videos each individual arithmetic operations. Then logical operations. Logical operations are nothing but testing two conditions. If this condition is true or this condition is false, what will happen? What has to be taken? So it helps in following the conditional statements. So it perform 8-bit basic logic operations. Logic instructions, they also modify the flag bit. Some of the logical operations are AND, ANA, ANI, AND immediate, ORA, OR, XORA, CMC is complement the value in the accumulator, and so on. Then rotate, shift right, shift left, all those things will come under the logical operations. And they will definitely affect the flag registers. Then branch operations. Branch operations is jump loop. In other languages, we have for loop, do loop, and also on. So like that, we have loops in here. So for that, we use the branch operation. Some of the branch operations are jump on no carry. Based on the flag bit, a decision will be taken. Whether the carry bit is set or not. Whether the auxiliary carry bit is set or not. Whether the parity bit is set. Already we have seen what are the flag bits available in the microprocessor 8085. There are 5 flag bits. They're nothing but parity bit, sign bit, carry bit, auxiliary carry bit, and then zero bit. Yes. So based on the arithmetic operation or previous operations, those flag bits will be set or reset. So based on that, we can take a decision. So for that, these are all the instructions which helps in doing that. So we have unconditional program, and not only that, we have subroutines. You can write subroutines here. like functions, how you are writing functions in other programs, we write subroutines here by using call and return statements. So all these things comes under the branch operations. So they help you to take a decisions and execute a set of particular instructions based on the conditions. So for that we have branch operations. Then we have machine control operation. These are all special instructions such as IO data transfer, perform machine related operations. Halt, it is used to permanently stop the computer. When you press this halt button, it means it stops the performance of the microprocessor. Then no operation, to perform no operations. Then SIM, to set the masking of hardware interrupt. It is used to set and reset, SIM and RIM are set and reading the interrupt status and then take a decision accordingly. Then enable interrupt and disable interrupt. These combine with the SIM and RIM and do the interrupt operations. Now we'll see the other operation, that is whatever we have seen. We have seen data transfer operations and then arithmetic and machine control operations, branch operations and so on. So we are going to see in the next video each and every operations instruction execution in detail.